Today, Rihanna went on a trip with her school to the zoo in Nashville, and I decided to take my mountain bike to Sewanee and to ride around there. There's lots of miles of trails there. I've been wanting to go there for a long time. I went last August, and I went back today. It's April 10th, 2010, and I'm mountain biking in Sewanee on the parallel trail, and it's still early spring here. The leaves are just starting to bud out, and there's some dogwoods or redbuds blooming around here, and not much else. The occasional wildflower, but just kind of taking it easy here, not going too fast, riding on the trail here and trying to learn my way around this part of the domain here. After riding straight through the woods for a while, I came upon this cabin, and it looked like a nice log cabin next to the edge of the mountain. You could see the view, and there was evidence that people had been there camping and grilling, and it was an unusual looking thing. I had forgotten my map today, but when I got home I noticed it was called Forestry Cabin on the map, and it was about halfway between Rutledge Point and Dotson Point on the northwest side of Sewanee along the perimeter trail. This is Five Points. It's a point on the parallel trail where Five Points come together. It's kind of in the middle of this far west side of the Sewanee Domain. A lot of woods, and I just passed two bikers. Looked like experienced male bikers with their helmets and outfits on, heavy-duty bikes. But I'm just kind of taking it easy here, not wanting to get too hot and tired. I'm walking up hills sometimes, but this is farther than I got last August. Down that way is Audubon Lake, which is about as far west as I got in the central part. I did go around further west along Brakefield Road, but this is where I'm at right now. A little bit past Five Points, I came to this sign that said Forest Restoration Project, and I was a little bit concerned about this because it looked like there was just a bunch of logging going on, but I guess it is for a good purpose to thin out some of the old trees. Although it got a little bit muddy here, I took a little excursion south and came back to the perimeter trail and walked on that little bit, by foot, and saw some of the unusual rock formations that you often see here at Sewanee around the area. They are very unusual rock formations. Then I went back onto the trail I was on and came to Brushy Lake.
I sure have a lot of lakes here at Sewanee. This is Brushy Lake. It's a little man-made lake and a little earthen dam here, overflow. They've really got several of these. quite nice.